Hello, beautiful people. How's it going? No.
We're beautiful. Future.
My regular niffler.
Hello, beautiful people. How's it going? I'm back with another video, and today I wanted to debunk a theory that has just been getting on my nerves that I've been seeing all around Twitter and Instagram and Facebook and YouTube. And it's the idea that Grindelwald was lying to Credence at the end of Fantastic Beasts: The Crimes of Grindelwald. And while I understand that fans were so shocked by the revelation of Aurelius Dumbledore, spoiler alert, that they just couldn't believe it, and they thought that there is no way that this could be true, so Grindelwald was lying, and the climax of the movie had no purpose, and therefore makes the entire film irrelevant in the Harry Potter series. While I understand that the Aurelius Dumbledore story came out of left field because we are led to believe that we understand the entirety of the Albus Dumbledore family and the Dumbledores and everything that happened in Godric's Hollow because we were introduced to them in the Harry Potter series. Now, while I understand that this is canon, 100%, there may have been stuff that was left out, and I know very specifically from my time on the channel that there is a huge difference, as I've learned, between retconning and introducing new things. Now, while I understand that Aurelius Dumbledore may not specifically fit into the timeline, there is a whole theory that I made on the Obscurus and Ariana Dumbledore and how those can link together. So if you're interested in that, I'll leave the link in the description below and you can check that out. But now, I wanted to talk in depth about the final scene of the film, and I'm gonna use my copy of Fantastic Beasts: The Crimes of Grindelwald, the original screenplay. I mean, I don't know why they call it the original screenplay. I mean, as if there's like a second edition, or maybe in the future, when the series is over, they'll like release a second edition. But for now, it's called the original screenplay, for no reason, apparently. Credence inhales sharply. His chick steps onto Grindelwald's palm. Grindelwald throws it in the air where it catches a light. Given room at last, the bird stretches its wings and becomes full size. The bird is aflame, a phoenix reborn. Okay, people on Twitter and YouTube have been saying that because Grindelwald held the phoenix, he was the one who transformed it into a phoenix, essentially, and that was the reason Credence believed that he was a Dumbledore. And I understand that Credence obviously doesn't know who the Dumbledores are, so the revelation is just completely irrelevant to him, other than the fact that he has his official identity back. The reason I feel like this is false and the phoenix is actually real is because of two things. First thing, the phoenix was present throughout the entire film. There was even a scene where Credence was feeding the chick when him and Nagini met Grindelwald for the first time. Now, I understand that some other people were also saying that, hey, Grindelwald was there, so he may have put the chick, like, over there for Credence to see it and then see him. To me, it just doesn't make sense, and to me, it would just be outstretching everything. And one thing we know about Joe's writing, whether you say you enjoyed Crimes of Grindelwald or not, we know for a fact that Joe wouldn't just leave all of these breadcrumbs only for them to be completely irrelevant in the grand scheme of things. And let me rephrase once again and really, really reiterate and emphasize the fact that if this was a lie and this Aurelius Dumbledore twist wasn't true, this entire film becomes irrelevant in the Fantastic Beasts series. Not only in the Harry Potter Wizarding World franchise, but in the entire Fantastic Beasts series, number two would be obsolete. The whole movie was about Credence figuring out who he was and Grindelwald's rise. So both of those things just becoming irrelevant because Grindelwald is a straight up liar, which is something we haven't seen in the entire series, by the way. Grindelwald has never lied, never blatantly. I mean, he's manipulated, he's said things, he's kind of gone back on his word a bit, but he hasn't lied, never once. And so for him to lie about something like this and just manipulate Credence in that way would literally make the entire movie just obsolete. And Jo wouldn't do that. She wouldn't paint herself as a very stupid writer because that would be a very stupid writing decision. Because it just takes all sense of suspense of disbelief and just throws it out the window. Because I know for a fact that if I believe that this was a lie, then I don't trust anything that any character says in the series whatsoever, and that would just mean that it's poorly written. And while some people do feel like Crimes of Grindelwald was poorly written, it's not to that extent. Not at all. I mean, to the extent where Credence would be receiving a lie. I mean, it just doesn't work. And in my opinion, the reason the Phoenix was set aflame when Grindelwald threw it into the air is because it was at the end of the film, and that's when the reveal needed to be revealed. And that was the only case in the film where we got a show don't tell kind of situation, since it was translated into a screenplay. So the fact that all of the fans are kind of like up in arms about the concept that, you know, we were shown the Phoenix bursting into flames and that could have been a lie, that just goes against the purpose of everyone complaining that the entire exposition scene where Leta Lestrange describes her flashback was told incorrectly because it was all told to us and not revealed. So the fact that the reveal scene is something that the fans are just like not happy about is just really, really irritating. And I wanted to kind of analyze that, but I also wanted to point out the main reason that I think this is not a lie and honestly cannot be a lie is because Credence becomes so powerful when he finally figures out who he is. And this entire movie was developing how his weaknesses are becoming his strengths. And so to give us, or to give Credence, that sense of self-belief and like that confidence, and then to have it be ripped away just as you learn that he is becoming very powerful with his Obscurus. I mean, let's be honest, when he got his wand and just blasted that Nurmengard castle place into pieces, it was the most powerful we've ever seen Credence. In fact, he was more powerful in that scene than a lot of the other wizards we saw in Fantastic Beasts, because he was channeling his Obscurus into the wand and therefore using his power finally. And so to have that be a build-up, to have that be the climax, and to definitely want to explore that in Fantastic Beasts 3, and then just be told that it's a lie, just doesn't seem right to me. And again, would emphasize the fact that it is horrible, horrible writing. And Joe wouldn't do that. However, I could be wrong. Joe could honestly, honestly be having a very, very bad writing year, and she could have written the most horrendous script I've ever seen. However, I enjoyed it very much, and I just don't buy the fact that it was a lie. I just don't. But I would like to know you guys' opinions. I mean, I know that a lot of my viewers are conflicted with the Crimes of Grindelwald, and I know that a lot of you are questioning how that could fit into canon, and how, you know, Credence is very young and Dumbledore is old and his parents died. Again, that's Obscurus talk that I'm almost certain is what's gonna happen with that whole Aurelius Dumbledore, Ariana Dumbledore kind of thing. Especially since we got information on Ariana Dumbledore in this film when Dumbledore and Leta Lestrange were having a conversation about siblings that have died. And I would like to mention that because that was the very first mention from Albus Dumbledore himself of Ariana Dumbledore in the entire movie series of Harry Potter and Fantastic Beasts, that again is foreshadowing and a hint as to what's to come later. So I know that in Fantastic Beasts 3 or 4 or 5, we're going to be getting information on Ariana Dumbledore, which then would directly link to Credence. And again, in terms of people who are saying that Joe might have just thrown that in and is coming up with all of this stuff just as a build-up, highly doubt it, because the way these things link together after you think about them, when you make theories that work out the way they do, everything comes to pieces and everything fits very well. And again, even though the reveal did come out of left field, Grindelwald was not lying, in my opinion. So thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave me a like and a comment down below, and subscribe to my channel to see a lot more Harry Potter and Fantastic Beasts content. Oh wow, we actually have to wait a good 2 years till Fantastic Beasts 2? Well, actually, a year and 11 months, you know. Oh god. It's a long wait, and yeah, it's a long wait. Bye, guys.